appreciate the significance in our lives. Bless everyone who are present here today. Each one of us may be able to share our knowledge, understanding, and wisdom for your glory and honor. May the parties and communities remain the public event and be a success through your intervention. We all ask of you in the mighty name of Jesus. So, to formally start this afternoon's program, we are pleased to have with us the Director of the Institute of Human Nutrition and Food, Dr. Amy Sherry Barion, to give us the welcome remarks. Let us give her a round of applause.
So, good afternoon, everybody. I see in my students, faculty members, colleagues, alumni. So, thank you for coming. Now, as the Director of the Institute of Human Nutrition and Food and as colleague of Dr. Clarice Awanico, I would like to say, I'm very proud and I admire very much Dr. Awanico with regards to her accomplishments and achievements. No? So, siguro pag sinabi natin yung core nutrition, sinonimus na automatic Awanico. Parang gano'n, no? Kasi talagang she has developed, she has proposed, she has done many researches on corn, mixed stimulants corn. So, I'm very proud and she's actually one of the assets of the Institute of Human Nutrition, not only sa UNIC but also sa college, I might say, no? And of course, university. So, recently, their group was also awarded, ano nga ba yung award for that? Wait, may screenshot ako dito. Ayun, other group, Corn for Food and Nutrition Security was awarded group category CSC-NCR Presidential Lingkod Bayan Award winner. So that's really a very big accomplishment, no? So talagang ang focus ni Ma'am Clarice talagang sa corn, no? Again, I'm very much an admirer ni Ma'am when it comes to her research works. Now, corn, as you may know, is one of the staples, no, sa Philippines. It's one of the most important crops in the world, and in the Philippines, marami din tayo corn, no? In the Philippines, corn is second most important crop after rice. So, we produce around maybe 2.5 to 3 million, no? Tons of corn sa Philippines. Kaya talagang ano niya talaga is yung utilization consumption medyo hindi natin naman maximize. And when we talk about food and nutrition security against malnutrition, undernutrition, stunting, it's very nice to look at our indigenous crops, and one of which is our corn in the Philippines. Visayas, Mindanao, ma'am, correct me if I'm wrong, no? Lalo na sa Mindanao, ang daming corn production, and normally, ginagamit lang siya as parang feeds. So, marami ding food waste ang na-accumulate. So, we have to talk, and this is one of our local indigenous crop, and it will be very nice to hear this afternoon. Sa Centennial Professorial Chair Lecture ni Dr. Lenis Bonico on how we can maximize the use of our local corn in the Philippines. So, alam ko, marami din recipe si Ma'am sa corn. Yan, no? Nakaibahan ng corn. So, mga students, alam ko lang ang Japanese corn. Buhay ko lang ng, ano, ng local. So, meron din tayo, yun yan tayo isi-share ni Ma'am na, ano, na mga corn sa Philippines na and how we can maximize its use when we talk about food and nutrition security. So, without further ado, congratulations nasa puli, Dr. Bonico. We are very proud of you. You are one of the assets of the university when it comes to research and also sa instruction. So, later on, we do na ito, baka si Ma'am yung director, ano, ano, sa, I'll pass on the baton kay Ma'am, no. So, she's also, ano, then, one thing na maganda kay Dr. Therese, and she is able to transfer her technology, kasi maraming ganun, it's really hard, actually, to transfer yung technology ng research. Minsan kami, yung research lang, eh, pero, I'm very much proud to say ngayon sa research ni Dr. Therese, no, she was able to transfer it by conducting mga training, seminars, at saka yung mga recipes, I think makikitikman natin ngayon, meron ba kami matitikman lang. Meron siya mga bread and ganon, so ma-amaze kayo sa development. And of course, information dissemination, this is one of, ano, pwede yung maikwento sa mga housemates mo, sa mga kapamilya. So, para talagang ma-help, ma-maximize yung corn production natin in the pan. So, malaking potential ng corn as a staple. Next to that. So, again, thank you very much and congratulations, Dr. Therese Juanico.
Thank you very much to Dr. Barion for that warm message. So, we agree now that we are very proud of Dr. Juanico because of her milestone. So, talaga namang pag sinabing corn, as Gen Z's and Millennials call it, si Ma'am ay Lodi talaga. So, yeah. So, we're very proud of her. So, let's clap our hands for her. So, and yes, I agree also with Dr. Barion that corn is underutilized. But Ma'am Bonico will further discuss on this topic later on. So without further ado, to do the honors of introducing our distinguished speaker, may we please call on the Head of Food Management and Administration Division of IHMF, Dr. Irma Danao.
Thank you po. Kaya ba po ang good afternoon, everyone. It is an honor to introduce our Centennial Professorial Chair Lecturer and one of our esteemed colleagues at the IHMF. Dr. Clarissa Bontillo Juanico is an Associate Professor and UP Scientist 1 from the Institute of Human Nutrition and Food, College of Human Ecology, UPLB. She obtained her undergraduate degree in nutrition from UPLB in 1992. In the same year, she took the Nutritionist Dietitian Licensure Examination and ranked second among the passers. Lodi Nana. Her master's degree in Applied Nutrition minor in Public Health Nutrition was granted in 2010, while her PhD in Human Nutrition minor in Food Science and Entrepreneurship in 2018. For both graduate degrees, she was awarded scholarship grants from the DOST-SEI. Dr. Bonico started her teaching career at UPLB in 2006. She has handled various courses in nutrition, including food service systems, meal management, nutrition and human development, nutritional assessment, food and nutrition for healthy life, food selection and preparation, food preservation, food and culture, and nutritional epidemiology. Prior to teaching, she spent almost 10 years in the food service industry. Dr. Ramico was a recipient of numerous grants and awards, including the Orange Knowledge Program Fellowship Grant, Nils van Hogstraten Foundation Research Grant, Sight and Life Educational Grant, DOSESEI Scholarship Grant, Leto Philippines Culinary Scholarship Grant, and the Union Ajinomoto Scholarship Grant. She has authored and co-authored several articles in both local and international journals and received several international publication awards. Dollar sign, ma'am. Okay. She is also a Centennial Professorial Chair and one UP Professorial Chair awardee in Human Nutrition for outstanding teaching and research. She had attended and presented, of course, no, papers in both international and local seminars and conferences. Among her research interests and involvements include public health nutrition, infant and young child nutrition, menu labeling, porn for health and nutrition, food service, and food safety. She recently concluded a research project funded by the Department of Agriculture, Bureau of Agricultural Research, with the title Development of Nixtamalized Philippine Corn for Food, Health, and Nutrition. Currently, she is the program leader of a DOST Calabar Zone funded project with the title Nutrient Rich and Ready to Eat Food Products Development and Innovations Utilizing Locally Produced Pigmented Corn Towards Enhanced Nutrition Across Various Age Groups in Region 4A. She is the study leader or one of the study leaders of the ongoing Nutrition Across ongoing DOST PCHRD funded project on utilization of Philippine white corn breeds as staple for improved nutrition, disease prevention and management in Calaria, Misamis Oriental. Performing the trilogy of functions expected of a UP faculty, Dr. Ramico is also actively involved in extension and public service activities as well as in administrative duties. She served as head of the Food Management and Administration Division and now currently the program leader and national coordinator of the BIDANI or the Barangay Integrated Development Approach for Nutrition Improvement Network Program, which promotes nutrition and development through a local participative and integrated management system. Recently, the Corn for Food and Nutrition team of Dr. Ramico, as what was Dr. Byron stated a while ago, was awarded the CSC-NCR Presidential Lingkod Bayan Award for a group category. Amazing, di ba? Just that. Ano yun? Zaya Mace. Okay. To deliver her Centennial Professorial Lecture, let us welcome the epitome of a person we greet, okay, our team corn, Dr. Carissa B. Ramico.
Thank you, ma'am, for the round of applause. I'm just going to siyempre, ano lang ako, corn princess. Corn princess. Kasi ang corn queen natin, alam natin, pag-arotana. And ang corn queen ay si Sir R. Salazar. So, kaya ako ay hindi ko ma-apin yung corn queen. Okay na, corn lady pwede rin. Okay, so, doon na relax ang sarili ko. So, thank you muna po for coming kahit na medyo kaibitan ngayon. Tapos, lang umulan. So, I hope na yung mag-drum up. So, I would like to thank my friends, my students, my colleagues, my advices, and yan, makalimitan nyo. The rest po. Thank you po. So, let me, ano na, no, start yung ating lecture for today. Okay, so, thank you for coming today and to attend this lecture titled The Food and Nutrition Potentials of Products Made from Nixtamalized
Philippine Corn. This lecture generally aims to share some of the highlights of the results of our recently concluded research project, the development of mixamalized Philippine corn for food health adaptation with focus on study 2. Specifically, this lecture provides provide an overview of the malnutrition and corn consumption in the country. Describe what is mixamalization. So, nasa ano kasi yung arutang twister. So, today we'll be defining talaga, describing what is mixamalization and its benefits. Share the optimization results of two Philippine corn varieties, the IPP bar 6 and the Lipan corn. Represent highlights of the recipe modifications and high value products developed using mixamalized corn. We'll discuss about the nutrient content and general acceptability of corn products made with mixamalized corn. And we'll discuss the potentials of addressing malnutrition by consuming products with mixamalized corn. So, to answer those objectives, we'll be following this outline. Okay. So, to start, the Philippines is challenged by the coexistence of different forms of malnutrition. So, we have our students here. So, you are not, I know you are familiar with the coexistence of malnutrition. The triple burden of malnutrition, that is undernutrition, overnutrition, and micronutrient deficiency coexist in many countries and even within the household. Okay? A family may have an overweight mother and a stunted child. According to a study by the Food and Nutrition Research Institute in 2021, one in every 10 households, so imagine one in every 10 households, had a mother and child pair with double burden of malnutrition, while a small proportion of households had a mother and child pairs with triple burden of malnutrition, so about 2.4%. The same household had overweight or obese mother and underweight and anemic child. So, triple burden talaga siya. The reality is, the Philippines is facing the challenge of addressing high rates of stunting, micronutrient deficiencies, and obesity. Coupled with food insecurity, the triple burden of malnutrition threatens the survival, the growth and development of children, economies, and society. Okay. Micronutrient deficiencies are not well quantified or undiagnosed due to unclear specific symptoms. According to the Food Consumption Survey in 2018-2019, iron, calcium requirements were met by the least percentage of households at only 5.8% and 12.4% respectively, while the 2015 data show that the prevalence of zinc deficient Filipino is at 25.6%. Okay. Micronutrient deficiencies can lead to morbidity and mortality. Deficiencies can have severe consequences, including increased susceptibility to infections, stunted growth, muscle weakness, growth retardation, cognitive impairment, decreased school performance and work productivity, and worse, even death. This lecture will limit the presentation into three micronutrients. So we have iron, calcium, and zinc, because these are the three micronutrients given emphasis in the bracket. Okay, so calcium is essential for bone formation, smooth muscle contraction, nerve transmission, and others. It accounts for around 1.9% of total body weight. Generally, calcium-rich foods are often found in dairy and milk products, which as we know, is usually not accessible or not affordable for all. Iron is an essential element in the all cells of the body that plays a vital role in oxygen transport and cellular respiration. Without enough iron, there are not enough red blood cells to transport oxygen, which leads to fatigue. Iron is important for healthy brain development and growth in children. and for normal production and function of body cells and hormones. The most bioavailable source of iron is found in animal sources such as pork, poultry, beef, fish, and liver. Plant sources or the non-eating sources such as rice, bread, green leafy vegetables, and legumes do not have the highest bioavailability unless taken with vitamin C. Zinc plays a diverse role in carbohydrates, lipid, protein, and nucleic acid metabolism. The richest dietary sources of zinc include red meats, liver, fish, eggs, milk, nuts, and legumes. The availability of zinc in plant products is decreased by the presence of fiber and phytates, which bind to zinc, rendering it unavailable. So now, let's focus on rice and corn consumption in the Philippines. Filipinos are known as typical rice eaters, and rice itself has been part of the Filipino culture. The Philippines ranks third among the top rice importing countries in the world according to the U.S. Department of Agriculture Foreign Agricultural Service. However, the Philippines' total rice tax fell by 19.8% in July 2020 compared to the same month in 2019, which translated into a dramatic decrease in supply from 2.6 million metric tons to 2.1 million metric tons. In addition, inadequate land resources, rapid increase of the population, natural calamities, and limited access to innovations and new rice technologies have contributed to the decline in the country's rice production. In order to help reduce the importation of rice, the use and consumption of corn as one of the underutilized crops is being encouraged by the Department of Agriculture. Corn is the second most important crop in the Philippines, yet it is underutilized for human consumption. While corn varieties serve as staple food for only around 15% of the population, especially in the Visayas and Mindanao. Mainly, the usual method of corn preparation prior to consumption does not maximize its nutritional benefits. Unless prepared using specific methods, the nutritional value of corn is left marginal. And people depending on it as main food resource may suffer from malnutrition. Hence, a technique that would enhance its nutritional quality is therefore essential. Mexico and Central America is using a technology called nixtamalization. Based on several studies, nixtamalization enhances the functional and nutritional properties of corn, hence can be utilized to improve the nutritional value of corn and its products. Okay. So the Department of Agriculture Bureau of Agricultural Research, or DAR, funded a research project which aimed to contribute to the attainment of food and nutrition security through utilization and processing of corn cultivars in the Philippines, with focus on two local corn varieties, the IBB-R6 and Lagitan corn. This project was implemented at the Institute of Human Nutrition and Food, College of Human Ecology in UP Los Baños. Information on the quality, nutritional value, and health-promoting properties of nixtamalized corn hopes to increase the demand for corn as a strategy to augment the supply of rice commodities in the country. So now let's discuss about nixtamalization. Nixtamalization is a traditional food processing method by the indigenous Mesoamerican civilization since 1200 to 500 BC. That is still applied in the modern world. The traditional way of nixtamalization follows the cooking of corn kernels in lime water, then steeping it at room temperature that happens overnight. During nixtamalization, the elevated pH and high temperature facilitate the softening of the endosperm and the release of the pericarp of corn. The cooking and steeping liquid is removed after steeping. The alkaline cooked kernels are then washed using water to remove the excess lime. The same time, other parts of the pericarp which are reduced throughout the process. So, actually, there are a lot of studies already about mixtamalization. Several studies have been conducted about the effect of mixtamalization, including the numerous physical and biochemical changes in form. Among the claims and results of the studies are as follows. Mixtamalization improves the bioaccessibility of calcium and vitamin B3 or niacin. It can enhance the protein digestibility and positively affect the protein quality of corn by adjusting the disproportion leucine to isoleucine ratio. Mixtamalization improves the content of resistant starch, which results in a lower glycemic index, as we know, good for people with diabetes. According to the chair of the WBFI, the mixtamalization procedure can release carotenoids from the kernels, resulting in 100 times more carotene in the dough or in the masa. Mixtamalization can cause an increase in the protein content of raw corn. So according to Bersani and I, mixtamalization of corn increases the calcium content by about 18-fold. Higher amounts of iron and zinc were also observed in the same study. Several studies also found that mixtamalization can decrease the phytic acid, which in turn increases bioavailability of iron. Saturating phytic acid with calcium will prevent iron from binding to phytic acid, thus increasing ionizable iron. Moreover, mixtamalization also improves the calcium-phosphorus balance, which is important in bone development. Aside from the nutritional benefits, mixtamalization can also decrease the mycotoxin levels in corn. Among these nutritional benefits of mixtamalization, one of the most important contributions given our problems in the micronutrient malnutrition is the significant increase in the mineral content of alkaline cooked corn, especially calcium and iron, as compared to their raw counterparts. Corn itself is not a good source of calcium, but alkaline cooking or mixtamalization can increase its calcium contribution in the diet. Okay, so to better understand mixtamalization, let's discuss the process and methods. Mixtamalization process consists of two stages. It's basically cooking and steeping the corn in an alkaline liquid. Both stages cause water and calcium to be absorbed by the grain. Currently, there are three types of mixtamalization based on the alkaline agent used. Traditional, classical, and the ecological mixtamalization. The traditional process of mixtamalization is the cooking of corn grains in a lime solution for 10 to 30 minutes at 85 to 100 degrees Celsius, soaking for 8 to 16 hours, and then washing them by hand to remove the pericarp. One of the issues encountered by food processors which utilize traditional mixtamalization is its negative impact on the environment because of the high pH of the wastewater. In another type of mixtamalization, instead of using lime, the classic mixtamalization process uses wood ash in the alkaline cooking of corn. The ecological mixtamalization process uses calcium salts instead of lime. This method gives higher yield of corn flour and products and improved nutritional quality. The procedure follows the same method with that of the traditional mixtamalization, but this uses calcium carbonate. Okay, so mixtamalization should be foreign to us Pinoy because I assume we are all familiar with or have eaten and at least once in our life, binatog. Okay? So yes, binatog is a product of made out of dried mature waxy corn kernels soaked in alkaline water using apoc or calcium carbonate. So kung nakakain na po kayo ng binatog, nakakain na kayo ng mixtamalized corn. Okay? So, yun po. Okay, so we hypothesize improvements in the nutritive value and health-promoting substances related to corn mixamalization. TA bar target the project development of mixamalized living corn for food, health, and nutrition by developing household recipes and high-value products of nutritional significance using IPV bar 6 and Lagitan corn kernels, grease, and flour. To give us an idea how the project conducted mixamalization in the lab, let's watch this short video.
Project optimized the ecological mixamalization process using two locally available corn varieties. To make mixamalized corn kernels, the materials you need are corn kernels, rice cooker, distilled water, calcium carbonate, and a weighing scale. 1 kilogram of corn is cooked in an automatic rice cooker for 20 minutes. This is cooked using a combination of calcium carbonate and distilled water. The kernels or mixtamal is then taken off the heat and let sit in the cooking liquid for 2 to 6 hours. Afterwards, the mixtamal is drained and washed to get rid of any extra alkali. The mixtamal is then dried in a benchtop dehydrator for 16 hours. After drying, you can either mold the kernels into corn grits or grind them into flour depending on what you prefer.
Okay, so may kasama kasi isa lang na may least distansya pa. So yung nakasama ng presentation na yun. Okay, so let's continue. One of the objectives of the project was to optimize the mixamalization procedure for the two corn varieties. The three main processing factors that were treated as variables in the study were the steepy pine. So kasi medyo matagal, no? So may mga basal literature, mayroong umaabot ng overnight or 16 hours ng steeping time. So the project optimized the procedure. So the steeping time, the cooking time, how long ba talaga ang cooking time using our own variety. Kasi nasa literature natin, based on studies abroad, they use different varieties of corn. So for the bar 6, IPV bar 6 and Lagitan, we wanted to develop an optimized procedure. So the steeping time, the cooking time, and also the alkali concentration. So here in the figure is the result of the optimization study. So by the way, the optimization study is headed by our assistant professor, Arvin Paul Duane. So don't ask me about the optimization later, you can ask. Okay. So just to share the highlights of this portion of the project, the optimized procedure is a kilogram of dried corn kernel is boiled in a lime solution containing 1% of calcium carbonate with only 2 liters water for 20 minutes. Okay, so the optimized procedure, so we use only 20 minutes instead of a longer cooking time as presented or used in the traditional method, which is up to 40 minutes. The optimized steeping time for IPV bar 6 is at 2 hours at room temperature, while for Lagitan time, the optimized steeping hours is 6 hours. Then it is followed by draining and drying the kernels. Dried kernels can now be processed into grits or flour, depending on how we will utilize the mixamalized one. Okay, so all these products in the photo are the mixamalized corn products we developed in the project. And we have the recipe here. So, nandito po, if you want to cook, no, to try. But you have to learn how to mixamalize first. This recipe contains the ingredients and the procedure of how to prepare it at the household level. Recipes of common Filipino snacks were modified and high-value food products were developed using mixamalized IPV bar 6 and Lagitan corn kernel, grits, and flour. Okay, so the product developments target with recipe identification. So hindi basta maisip lang natin kasi yung gumawa tayo ng bunchy or gumawa tayo ng mahaplang ka. So we started with recipe identification, which is based on the characteristics of IPB-6 and Lactitan corn, particularly its amylose and amylopectin content. IPB-6 generally contains more amylose at 28.10%, while Lactitan heavy 45%. So thus IPB-6 is more appropriate for food items with firm and dry texture, while Lactitan is more appropriate to food products with soft and sticky texture. Moreover, in consideration to the food Filipino food patterns, the chosen food products were generally under the categories of bread, beverage, and traditional Filipino snacks. So we wanted to promote this in our community, in our household, so it's something they are familiar already. Okay? So what are the products developed and the modified recipes that we conducted in the study? Okay, ito siya. Shown here are the typical Filipino foods and snacks that were cooked using either wheat flour or rice flour. No? So, andun po, may kuchita, puto, mahablanga. So, most of our nutrition students, I believe you know how to cook this at home. And we are familiar, we know that we use all-purpose flour or glutinous rice flour in cooking them. Okay, so we make a range of percent substitution from 0 to 100%, no? So total replacement or partial. So the sensory quality and acceptability of the products were the basis in determining the final percentage of mixed amylase corn substitution. So given in the third column, so for kuchinta, we have 50% of the original ingredients from, say, all-purpose flour was substituted with mixed amylase IPB-6 flour. And these are the picture. Okay, so for puto, okay, so the most acceptable proportion or acceptable treatment of puto is those or that version substituted with 32%. Okay, and later group use will be able to to taste this puto for snacks or mixed amylase corn puto. And syempre, hindi pa yun, ano? Other than puto, meron tayong mixed amylase pizza, okay? From, alagang snacks ang pinalakas. From halatang natutumlat ko tayo, no? So, mixed amylase crust. To be served or catered by Diaz Pizza. I believe you are familiar with Diaz Pizza already. So later po, ay matitignan po natin. So let me know kung tama ba yung aming sensory evaluation results na talagang the acceptability is still that high or always hindi mo mararecognize na may corn siya or kahit na meron siyang corn, the acceptability is very good. Okay. So, and what else? Mahablangas, only 19%. For pancake, so this pancake mix is also the same mix we use for the puffing. Okay? And we substituted it with 31% mixed amylase IPB-6. Fresh pasta, you can also make spaghetti and pasta dishes using mixed amylase corn, no? With 25% substitution. Low bread is 5%. And for panisal, it's 30% substitution. Okay, we also developed a fermented corn beverage. So this is similar to yogurt, no? And this is 50% substitution. So very high. We also have rice corn blend. So 30% for the IPB-6 variety. Later on, meron din po tayo sa Latina. Okay, so the next food items are the products which we substituted with Lactitan corn flour, mixed amylase Lactitan. So espasol with 38%, alitaw with 26%, and buchi, ayan, 25%, ginataang halo-halo, 40%, karyoma, 26%, and the rice corn blend. If you use Lactitan, you can substitute aside as 50%. So basically, what we want to show here is anything pala na with all-purpose flour or with bread flour, we can substitute with a more nutritious mixed-analyzed corn flour without compromising the quality. Okay, you will get more nutrients, you will get more minerals, especially calcium, at the same quality. Okay, so after, to come up with the recommended substitution or recipe modifications of other than recipe standardization and sensory evaluation. So just to share, no, nagsisensory evaluation kami was during pandemic. Okay, so can you imagine the difficult? So, dito ba si Sir Paul? Okay, so Sir Paul, dito ba siya top, di ba? But, it was one of our conducted sensory evaluation following the straight DOH protocol, no? So talagang pupunta ka sa bahay, no? So sa household group with sensory evaluation. Results show that the general acceptability of corn products made with mixed-analyzed corn flour were comparable to that of the products made using 100% all-purpose flour or rice flour. Substituting around 5 to 50% with mixed-analyzed corn flour provided nutrient enhancement without affecting the acceptability of the products. Okay. So this is a sample computation showing the increase in the calcium content of mixed-analyzed corn puto. A piece of puto substituted with 32% mixed-analyzed corn flour had a significantly higher calcium and a comparable amount of iron and zinc. So ito po siya. So one piece of puto later will provide 25 milligrams calcium. Isang piraso lang yun. You will have two. You can have 50. But that is for the flour alone. No? We prepared our puto with milk and cheese. So additional calcium pa. So we're actually having high calcium snack this afternoon. Okay, so yan. Review natin to attend mga faculty, the last University Council meeting where the El Circulo Cafe served sandwiches using this modified loaf bread recipe with 5% substitution. Okay, so sino po ang nakatend ng council meeting? I think galingan yun eh, nag-online kasi dahil I think for some reason, ano kaya, hindi lahat is nakatikin. So that sandwich was loaded with calcium because other than the calcium from the corn flour, it is also made with beetroot milk and cheese from beetroot. So again, high calcium. Okay, so the following articles presents highlights about the products we developed from the mixed-analyzed corn project. This article of Leon et al. Reported that the use of mixed-analyzed IPB bar-6 flour as an ingredient in the loaf bread making have improved its crude fiber content, calcium, and iron levels and can be a nutritious potential substitute ingredients for baked products other than loaf bread. Okay? Sulito et al. In this article, physical, chemical, and nutritional properties of mixed-analyzed quality protein maize flour and its potential as substitute in the Philippine soft bread, that is pandesal, concluded that the product showed desirable contributions in terms of the nutritional value and sensory attributes when used as flour substitute or blend. Okay, so this one, this is from Ramos et al., our host, published in the Journal of Soil Science. It says here that the fermented mixed-analyzed meat beverage exhibited higher protein, carbohydrates, and lower fat than commercial yogurt, showing that it is a healthy snack alternative which can promote meat consumption and utilization in the Philippines. Okay. The mixed-analyzed APB bar 6 ay nagkitang corn grits. So, hindi lang po lahat one, no? So, we also have grits. They're also blended with rice as this article from Hernandez et al. Showing that the blends exhibited significant increase in the calcium, iron, zinc, and phosphorus as compared to pure rice. So, there are more articles showing enhanced nutrition made possible with mixed-analyzation. Okay, but I will not be enumerating all. Okay, so for the key takeaways, to conclude, One way of addressing malnutrition is through the introduction and development of food products with improved nutritional value. Corn is an underutilized crop for human consumption despite its potential nutritional benefits. These nutritional benefits can be further enhanced through nixtamalization, and the resulting nixtamalized corn flour may be used in developing nutritious homemade snacks and products. Information dissemination about the benefits of consuming nixtamalized corn will help our corn farmers in improving their livelihood because of increased demand for corn. If there is higher demand, more farmers will produce corn, and then we are actually helping provide solutions to rice insufficiency. Nixtamalization and fermentation can be considered beyond the usual food processing techniques, but also nutrition processing. So, hindi lang ito pang food science, pang food tech. So, we can claim, we can use nixtamalization and fermentation as nutrition processing. Why? Because it enables increase or improvement in the nutritional profile of the developed food products, which can help contribute to providing solutions to our malnutrition problems. The available data on the nutritional content and availability of selected minerals of nixtamalized corn flour can be used as basis for future research to optimize the method and maximize its potential effects. Researchers focusing on the refinement and commercialization of nixtamalized corn products and recipes as a healthier alternative staples and snacks is encouraged. Also, that's my last slide, so I would like to acknowledge, take this opportunity to acknowledge our thank the Department of Agriculture, the Bureau of Agricultural Research, the Institute of Human Nutrition and Food, Ma'am Amy, for all the supporting and dami namin request sa kanya during the conduct of this project, and never kami tinanggihan ni Ma'am Amy, of course, FMAT, who with our division head, Dr. Dana, supported this presentation today. The project team, so we have Dr. Achenza, I don't know where to see here. So Dr. Achenza is part of the project, and also Assistant Professor Arvin Volcano, and all our research assistants, no? So syempre, ang mga dating graduate students, and ngayon ay si Arvina, we have Barbara Leon, Patricia Ramos, and Jessica Hernandez. So sila ang iyong mga, ano, princesses to be niya, okay. And of course, the prop committee with our prop chair, so Dr. Yulian, for representing this lecture today. And we did not forget my mentor, so ito ang nag-influence, nagturo sa akin, nagpakilala sa akin what is nixtamalization, Dr. Art Salazar. So lahat ko na sinasabi ko ngayon ay siya po ang nag-introduce and encourage me to conduct studies, and yet, and very true po na ang dami pa pong research gaps na pwede natin alamin about nixtamalization. So currently, we have submitted another proposal to Biribar as part 2 or phase 2 of this project. So hopefully, yun po ay ma-approve. So that would be all. Thank you for listening.
Okay, so thank you very much to Dr. Clarissa Romico for sharing that valuable knowledge on the food and nutrition potentials of products made from nixtamalized wheat and corn. So, iba yung nixtamalization, parang sa una, parang very alien term siya, ang nixtamalization, ano kaya yun? Pero, Ma'am Maniga has explained to us that yun pala ang nixtamalization. So, and who would have thought na yung ating traditional snacks can be made more nutritious with nixtamalized corn? Okay, so, talaga namang may sarap na, may isustansya pa. So, for those who have questions po, you may ask later during the open forum session. So, moving on to the next part of the program, to give us the discussant's remarks and salient points of the lecture, may we call on the assistant professor from the Institute of Food Science and Technology, Dr. Relecho Regina Jr. Let's give him a look.
Thank you. So, friends, I would like to thank Dr. Juanito for that very interesting professorial lecture at talk. And I would like to thank all the guests participants in this talk. Okay, let's proceed to my comment. Malnutrition has plagued our country for decades. The government announced this year that it has borrowed 10 billion pesos from the World Bank to fund the 4-year Philippine Multisectoral Nutrition Project, or PMNP, which aims to reduce the incidence of malnutrition. According to the World Bank, malnutrition has been a serious problem in our country for nearly 30 years. Our country ranks 5th among countries in East Asia and the Pacific with the highest prevalence of stunting. Most disturbing is that, according to the United Nations Children's Fund, 95 Filipino children die every day from malnutrition. This is equivalent to around 27 out of every 1,000 children failing to reach their 5th birthday. Because of the enormous human and economic losses, malnutrition deserves to be one of the Philippines' top national priorities, along with other pressing issues such as poverty, climate change, and national security. The lecture titled "The Food and Nutrition Potentials of Products Made from Nixtamalized Philippine Corn" was a game changer in addressing malnutrition through the introduction, enhancement, and development of food products using nixtamalized corn. The research studies conducted under this theme may have the potential to solve issues concerning rice importation in our country, as it promotes the utilization of corn as a rice substitute and a staple food. According to studies, the typical rice-centric diet of the Filipino population is inadequate in achieving a diverse diet. In order to address food security, a growing population, and a lack of food diversity, corn as an alternative food could offer a wide range of nutritional benefits. These benefits were set to an even higher level by studies that introduced nixtamalization to enhance the corn's intrinsic functionality. The lecture mentioned that applying the process of nixtamalization to corn could enhance its nutrient composition, and more importantly, its bioavailability, or the amount of nutrients available and absorbed that could potentially benefit our bodies. Indeed, this part of the study is perhaps the most remarkable finding that the various studies conducted under this lecture have demonstrated. Increasing the bioavailability of our food is the key to getting the most nutrition out of our food. The lecture showed a good flow of ideas starting from the problems which are mainly malnutrition and food insecurity. Then the intervention of introducing nixtamalized corn, which is basically our local corn, causes in such a way that the nutritional profile of corn improved. And in the last part, in order to promote the nixtamalized corn as an alternative or complementary food source for consumption, optimization of the nixtamalization process and the application of nixtamalized corn in different food products were discussed. The general flow of the lecture was very engaging and provided in-depth knowledge on the topics under discussion. However, it would be more complete if data on the production of local varieties of corn were also discussed. This is because if all of these innovative products were to be materialized, how would it be guaranteed that there would be a continuous supply of local varieties of corn to be used in such food development? The production data of local corn varieties will provide information on the sustainability aspects of externalized crop products. For prospects, evaluation of rheological properties of externalized corn or the external dough would be a great area to explore. A specialized rheological equipment such as an alveolograph will be helpful to identify the baking properties of the externalized corn flour to help us identify what other products can be made from such a food ingredient. In addition, this will also help us to expand more to other roster of food products that can target different age groups of Filipino consumers. Thank you, Paul.
Thank you, Dr. Florencio, for providing your notable insights on the lecture. So, we will now proceed to the open forum. So, for those who have questions for our speaker, kindly raise your hand and we will hand you the microphone. So, we'll have our first question, po. Any questions? Yes.
Pwede po sa retired po ako ng nagtuturo ng math. Pag-ibig yung math. Okay, first I'd like to congratulate Ma'am Juanico. Thank you for inviting us to this para lifelong learner ako and upgrade lover ako. Kaya, along with our pandemic, concretes na talaga. I'm so convinced about it. My question is on the economic side. Assuming that there is a sustainable supply of corn and accessible siya, kasi ako nung alam kung puro ko sa IBB, wala naman kasi available na outlet na malapit. So, isa yan, yung accessibility. Assuming na solved that yun, ano kaya ang major na objection ng mga tao na produce ng products ng mga masasarap natin mga kanin? Compared to the externalized corn, mas cost-wise, mas ma-purable ba siya? Or pareho lang? Or mas ma?
Kasi nga malayo, kasi nga nakausapan namin yung binato. So I'm sorry, hindi talaga ako makahanap ng binato for this after this na. Nagkaroon naman tayo ng puto. So to answer yung question, actually the project also include the economic aspect no, of producing mixed analyzed corn. So it's true, would it be same price of when you use our purpose flour or will it be cheaper or will it be more expensive? So yung tinapicto natin dahil we use it for computation is large scale. So mababa pa ang volume ng production. So ang computation na is around 70 pesos per kilo ang mixed analyzed corn flour. So when we are doing the project, mas mura pa ang corn noon. Pero ngayon, mas mahal na rin ang nabibili namin corn. And may syempre, diba, bigyan ka talaga ang mga process ng flour ngayon. So, I think, mas mahal siya given that the volume of computer is also small. But if we will push, no? So as I mentioned earlier, we have a proposal as a phase two of the project. So we wanted to make it a small scale or parang magkaroon ng production ng bread. So yung ano na, actual na. So we can compute for the talagang mas level up na production. Yung question ko ng supply, gusto ko pong answeran, sabi kasi ni Ma'am Arely, halimbawa, answer na siya, hindi siya. Actually, that is one of the problems din po, yung supply, no? So, kaya yung gusto natin i-ano dito is, if we will be provide, if we can provide talagang yung evidence-based na on the health aspect of care and externalized corn, tataas ang demand, so we can encourage more corn farmers to produce corn kasi currently I think some of them or most of them are planting other crops kasi nga hindi naman malaba naman ang demand sa corn. So kung tataas na ang demand for corn, magtatayo sila, dadaan sila, mas mumura na rin ang corn. So we can produce, we can process, we can request for funding siguro kung paano yung mga equipment na na-mention din ni Sir Blo kanina. So at the end, talagang win-win para sa lahat, from farmers and of course the Philippine people, improving our nutrition situation using one. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Pwede yung itanong honest? I was thinking kasi tayo nakakaintindihan ano, kasi nasa academy tayo. But while waiting for that to happen na magkaroon ng project, na magkaroon ng mga equipment, para mas maging available, how do you envision to bring this to the grassroots? For example, I would like to envision that since you are here, sana meron ba kayong study na mag-improve yung status ng proper nutrition sa buong Los Baños? Parang kahit hindi naman sa katabi natin. Parang how do you envision na maipalaganap ito sa mga taong bayan na ma-communicate yung technicalities doon sa mga taong na gusto natin makatap ng ganito na process. Thank you, ma'am. So actually, hindi na yung vision, we actually started that already, no? So during the last part po ng project, we conducted a seminar, technology commercialization among our municipal nutrition office ng Los Baños, attended by the Barangay Nutrition Scholars. So nag-conduct po kami ng seminar, pinresent po namin ito sa kanila. And we, we did the instruction, tinuruan namin sila kung paano magluto, gawin, and paano i-explain sa mga household. No? And we also got their commitment, our right now, to utilize this technology kasi meron silang community bakery po doon. So they are providing mga Nutriban. So ito pong products natin dito is ay nasa list po ang pwede nila provide sa kanilang mga feeding program. So yun nga lang po, babalik po tayo dun sa supply again na mixed-analyzed corn flour. So ang idea po namin dito is we will teach them, let's say, per barangay ba o per municipality, magkakaroon sila ng way how can they make their own or produce their own mixed-analyzed corn flour. Nagagamit po nila sa kanilang municipal bakery para mag-produce ng mga Nutriban or Pantisal or all of the products we develop. Para rin po ang ating mga pinakakain sa ating mga children, mga school children. Kasi di ba may sawa factor eh, rural diversity. So hindi yung every day and all days of the week ay Nutriban ang kakainin nila. So there should be variety and at the same time we're providing different foods, different nutrients sa kanila. So ma'am, we started na. So yun nga lang po totoo ng our hands are tied. Ang hirap talaga humilas na you have the plans, you wanted to share, pero financial no, ang ating kulang and also ng power. Pero kapunta po tayo, hindi naman po tayo tumitigil paghanap ng funding for this technology to be shared to others.
Thank you po for a very cool question. So do we have another question po? Questions po?
Mga students natin, may question.
Bonus points daw sa students niya.
Yes, sir.
Okay, since this is your having this, kasi malaki ko sa tingin ngayon is wasted and severely wasted for aking mga students. So, it can also be forced to get it for the PD program if we really want to institutionalize it. Pero kaya na din, may already have a month supply kasi auto-propose na yan, magbigla nagan, magwala na ng supply. So, yun lang po, ako yung future thinking lang po na kasi nag-usap-usap sila sa Senado eh, paano talaga yung budget. May budget naman po talaga, kung yun na is yung put more men sa ating mga early learners. Yun na po, kasi ang dami nga po data on wasted and severely wasted learners. Yun lang po, ma'am. More of a suggestion na nga kailan ay question.
Thank you, sir.
Parang yan ay connected naman po sa aming DST funded project, yung nutrient rich and benefit snacks development using pigmented corn naman. So yun nga po, hindi na tayo white corn, pigmented pa. So yun po ay snacks naman for school children. Ang ano po, ang idea po ng DST nga, yung produce naman po sa mga school children.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, yes.
Ayun, congratulations.
Alam na po, ang galing lang, no? Kasi, okay yung bread at saka pizza, no? Kasi we are good people at earlier. Kasi makakalim. Kasi nowadays, I think you deliver, labas din dati, no? Nag-survey, no? Ano mga traditional foods, like,
ang ba ang mas kuchanko po?
Nakalim na kayong mga kuchanko pa, mga alam nyo na po. Teenage pregnancy is fast rising in the Philippines.
Lumang teenager ka,
lumuntis, lumang. Walang bread kasi yung pizza, okay, yung bread. Kasi yung food, kasi makakakaunti na sa mga kabataan, hindi mga kabataan, tumato, mga young adults, yung mga nakal na mga kutsinta, ano ba yun? Espasol, so yung pizza, alam ko, gusto ng mga, ano kaya, yung bread o kumat. So, what I'm trying to say is naman, ano, yung guides po ng consumption, whether yung traditional foods like kunchita, yung mga kakanin, kung talaga, kasi baka matatanda naman ang kumakain na naroon, all these, no? Kung kailangan ko naman ang everything at action ka. Pero kung ang target talaga natin standing for yung mga soon to be pregnant para ma-prevent nga, eh, baka kung ano yung, ano ba kinakain yung noodles? Mga ano, baka, baka hindi yun lang namin yung ano nga, kasi nga baka ipipaper talaga for something in the future and others. So, syempre ang target natin yung future generation. Kung hindi naman sa masyado na nakakain minsan na lang, pag fiesta or nakakita, eh baka hindi masyadong ganun pa popular yung mga kuchinta, espasol, ano ba yung mga kakaryoka, umangaw, ang ganun mga atomat sa talaga ng membro, di ba? So, yung pizza, yes, di ba? Bread, okay. Okay, yung mga, yun lang yung ano, sa kakanin. Siguro baka pancake, nakit ako dun sa, ano, ako din sila, pancake. Kasi kung sila yung ating target nga, di ba, we have to consider yung likes and dislikes nila. Kasi baka yung mga oldies na lang yung sa mga kakanin eh. Although, hindi mo natin didisregard, pero medyo focus nga. Bread, noodles, siguro noodles nga, masusunod. No? Ano ba kinakain? Ano yung pasta na, o pizza, titikman natin, ma'am. Excited ka mo sa pizza ng mga puto, kahit mo paano. Or sport cakes, brownies, yung ba gusto nyo, yung mga, ano pa ba, may mga kitty, ma'am. O, yung lahat, ano. Yung lang, ano pa lang, baka lang kasi hindi na yung mga traditional na tayo nila na nakaka-appreciate, eh baka sila eh hindi na.
Thank you po ba. But so kasi nung ulit SP naman ito, start namin yung project ng SP. So ang talagang sinurvey our mothers. No? So kaya ang lumabas doon, yung mga talagang pangalan. No? Pinipigil back yung siguro yan, yung mga 195 students natin dito, yung mga to consider exploring this study. So at this age ba, sino pa may makilala sa Carioca at saka sa Palitao, Espasol, Pluto. So baka yun po, isa nga doon, no, that's a way to promote siguro traditional food, pero yun nga, correct, na we can include other dishes na popular or familiar ang ating age na ganito po.
Yes,
po ba? Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Sige niyo, hanggang po lang lahat po tayo.
We know may isa ninyo yung preferences with millen, yung young people. But taste is something that is developed. For example, ayaw nila ng gulay. So, kakayaan na lang natin na ayaw nila ang gulay. Diba? We have been trying them, diba? So, I think, siguro maging champion talaga yung IHNF or UPLB. But I would like to congratulate you for introducing the nutritious merienda dun sa, ano, sa council meeting. Kasi ang tagal kong nagpo-complain dyan, they were killing us soft with soft drinks and whatever. So, may balak ako mag-workout ko niya, pero sayang naman hindi ko inabot yung merienda naman sa council meeting. Congratulations kung sino naman yung pakala. But, I'm telling you is, pero naiintindihan namin na hindi ko alam yung Carioca. But that is
part of the Filipino culture. Yun ang mahirap sa atin eh. Bansa tayo nawawala sa sarili na dahil nga na ang may advertisement effect kasi eh. Pizza. Kaya. Bakit hindi natin i-explore lahat ng possibilities para ma-advertise properly yung nutritious naman. Kaya hindi tayo dapat mahihala pang matanggal food lang to. Ganun. So, ang suggestion ko is, paano kayo natin siya makapinalize sa UPLB? Maybe fun, maybe sa presentation, yun yung guna, nakita natin na may food art na yun, di ba? May vegetable art, may mga arupa, para sa ano. So, kasi clearly, kung ayaw ang bata ng guna, so, sige, ayaw ko din, ano, and then yun, yung LPBH, sinasabi nila na pababa na lang pababa yung age ng nagdadialysis na bata. Pababa na pababa yung age ng mga naka-hypertension. So, dahil nga, dun sa kinakain nila, ang unang tinatanong ng doktor, anong kinakain? So, hindi lang yun lang naman sa mga uri na yung soup. Ano ba yun? Yung mga instant soup na gano'n. Hindi kaya ng kidney nilang i-process yun. Nag-accumulate nila. So, yun ang ano ko, kakayaan ba natin kung sinabi nilang ayaw nila? Okay, sige, ayaw mag-iwa, parang ganun lang. Or, as parents or future parents, sabihin natin na this is good for you. Hindi naman pwedeng sila ang kasusunod. Alam mo natin kung ano ang tama, nandiyan na yung research. So, hindi pwedeng hayaan lang sila. Yun lang po ang aking suggestion.
Thank you, Paul. Ma'am, thank you. Actually, sa Patricia, ma'am, meron kami course ng food and culture, meal management, and this actually answers yung program going out on the university about nationalism. So, yun yan. I hope na appreciate niyo mga students namin. Maganda nga rin dati mga may GP kami ng food. Not 6 ma'am, ganun din ang gali. Pero kasi part doon yung ano, ma'am, may talaga. Ngayon, April, di ba, nagdadala ng chair ng parang mga GE courses. But before, ma'am, we need to have the GE on nutrition, yung part one talaga yung parang meal management, food and culture. So, actually, nagkat na lang, dami nag-shift sa amin eh, kasi na-realize nga na very interesting pala. So, yun, ma'am, to answer yung ano po na, meron din naman lahat, pero we try to be realistic din na sila, yun yung ano nila. So, yun, ma'am. So, meron naman, ma'am, kami ng ano. Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Mga lady ng comment.
Okay.
We have another question.
Hello, I'm Marilyn from the College of Development Communication. So, ang tinatanong ko, kasi nationalization is bago po sa akin. And so, as a student, I was really excited po to know more about it. And I'm sure po yung mga fellow students ko rin on the College of Telecom, I'm excited rin po on disseminating information about nationalization. So yung question ko po, magkakaroon po ba kayo ng mga programa in the future where students like us can partake in disseminating information about nationalization? Thank you po.
So, that's a very good opportunity for us kasi nga, totoo yun na isa may project ah, tapos narinig pa rin na this is already ano, include na itong project na ito. So, we conducted, we had several actually facilitated by the funding agency na kami kaming ginawang ito after nung matapos ko ito. But this is good if we can partner with our DepDom. So, at least, yung mga students natin, no, na sila yung, kasi sila yung nag-provide yung kanilang mga sinishare dyan, o parang, parang ma-introduce yung awareness, as I said in the last part of the presentation, the information campaign, information awareness, o yung pag-share ng information about nationalization, about using kayo na binatog, eh, next time, you will not look at binatog the same already, no? This is binatog, this is wow, binatog, kasi this is not just plug, this is with parang moral calcium, pero we have to look at the process kung paano ito ginagawa. Kasi as we said, sa optimization, there is a certain number of how many times you will wash or how many hours you will do the sleeping. So siguro baka pwede rin yung tumulog yung basic na pagagawa ng binatog ng community, baka pwede i-visit yung mga
gawaan, tulungan sila para tumigil yung natin more nutritious, more calcium rich, pwede po yan. But syempre, yun nga, sa resto ng ating student po ngayon, ako din. Okay, ng other po. So, you can start yung mga ganyang ano, small things in disseminating the information. Thank you.
Sir Abdi, you have a question.
Okay. Congratulations to our Queen Mother Destabilization. Okay. Now, this is more of a comment now. I think most of our audience here might wonder compared to sa sinabi ni Sir Flo about supply, etc. As of now, challenge talaga for our plant breeders, for our researchers in the crop sciences, white corn for food kasi ay open dominated variety. So, hindi siya hybrid. So, hindi siya sobrang taas mag-yield. And the reality in the country is that our corn farmers will prefer cultivating yellow corn for feed use. Kasi mas malaki yung kita doon. And actually, the endeavor of the age, monthlies, and the whole thing is to really provide evidences that there is an advantage of corn as a staple, as an alternative staple over rice. Hindi naman natin minimenos, talagang iba yung karakter ng rice. Kumbaga nasa pedestal yun. Pumasok man lamang po sa second level, di ba? But in any case, if there is a demand because of the nutritional and hormones along the way, the biomedical potentials of mixed Tamales corn or even white corn for food or even pigmented corn for food, sana yun yung magbigay ng signal sa government, sa different institutions. This is an interdisciplinary endeavor, di ba? So, yun yung vision natin na makita. And we are here to provide the proof, the hard evidences that, okay, sana pumunta na tayo soon sa feeding trials. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. So, actually, may feeding trial na ating practice sa Club Area. So, ayan, ito yung sisi ng Jessie. Kasi, she will study about the effect no, ng corn grits again, reversal of metabolic syndrome. So, in 2-3 years, so we hope to get the article or evidence kung ano ang reality na. No? So, yung gusto ko din mag-respond sa sinabi ni Sir Apti. No? So, yan, dito si Ma'am Lorna. So, tuloy-tuloy naman yung meeting. So, just recently, diba, we had a meeting with Sir Art sa Philip Maispa na so, pinag-usapan, this is hindi naman ito na isa sa tabi yung usapan. Nandun naman, lagi naman, sinishare natin yung mga concern about the production and the rest, so na-erase ko na, we're doing studies, we're doing this project, pero wala kang supply. So, mayroon naman po silang answer doon. So, talagang hindi lang ganun kabilis ang mga bagay-bagay, but siguro yung our own details of supporting and helping the project, makakarating po tayo ito. So, thank you po.
Okay, so we have another question,
Paul. Ayun, ma'am. Congratulations. Ako po si Josie Rayos sa DPUTLB. Kung alam na po yung LB Saver ng Cafe, project po ng UTLB yun. At part po si Ma'am Clarice doon. Siya po ang nagdadala, nagsisupply sa atin ng nixtamalized pizza crust. Kaya, matitikman nyo po, best seller po yun sa ano, sa cafe. Pinupromote po namin doon yung meat at milk-based products na kasama ang collaborating unit namin ay IHNF with Clarice at saka yung iba pong products ng UPLB. Pero napakaganda ang response ng stabilized pizza crust. Kasi ang daming gusto ni, ang dami, parang minsan nawawala na kami ng supply ng aming peso. Nawawala kami ng mozzarella, kasi yun yung nilalagay namin. So, meron konting gulay, pero most mostly, ang nilalagay natin doon sa pinsa-class ni Ma'am Clarice ay yung D3 cheeses lang. Tapos yun, gustong-gusto nila yun. Ma'am, thank you so much. At yan ang pakawin yung pan na lalagyan natin ng meat, yung halimbawa, yung ating lalagyan natin ng pan-meat, yung pan natin. Yung pa, pero hindi namin kayo ginagabal. Kasi alam namin busy kayo.
So, mayroon po ang pizza ng ECCL, circular apple. So, yun nga po, we are using externalized flour sa pagwapo ng class na yun. So, habang kinakain mo siya, you know that you are helping your bones. So, kung tayo sa puso, calcium, so less guilt pa. Hindi naman nakaka-guilty yun. So, yun po, dito po, nakita natin na may demand. So, madami pa kaming utang kay Ma'am Josie. May order siya ng low bread, may order siya ng buns na mayroong externalized form. So, kulang po talaga sa amin ang siguro time and power and investment. No? So, but we will try to sumala sa ating as well as well kaming current project. But we hope to increase our collaboration and supply ng bread with external ECC. And also with other siguro bake shops. So ngayon, later we'll try yung GS Pizza by Chef Abron. And po ay again may ano din po siya, externalized from that. But I think around 5-10% po ang substitution. Yes, Chef.
Do we have other questions, comments, suggestions? Okay, thank you so much. So thank you to our audience for your questions and to employees for the responses. So please remain in front, Dr. Renico. So we are now heading to the awarding of a certificate to recognize our speaker for the valuable knowledge that she has shared with us and to acknowledge her expertise in her field. So with much honor, I would like to call upon the Chair of RAP Committee, Dr. Caroline Piñon and Dr. Amy Sherry Barillon to present the certificate. Philippines Los Baños awards the UPLB Centennial Professorial Chair to Clarissa B. Renico, Institute of Human Nutrition and Food, College of Human Ecology, for her consistent exemplary teaching and research performance in the field of human nutrition, given this 11th day of September 2023 at the University of the Philippines Los Baños College Laguna, signed by Chancellor Jose B. Camacho Jr. Let's give her a round of applause. So, Dr. Piñon, we would like to request you to stay in front for the closing remarks. So, let's clap our hands for you.
Thank you, Ms. Patricia. I would like to ask everyone to give another round of applause for the service of the So, in behalf of our college dean, Dr. Ricardo Sangalo, and also our associate dean, Ma'am Ted Talavera, who is not with us. Unfortunately, she's sick. We would like to congratulate you for successfully presenting your lecture. So we have been planning this for a while. Finally, natuloy po siya today. So I'm sure after today, makakahinga na po tayo ng lalagay. Of course, we would also like to thank you, sir, Dr. Rino, for taking your time to be with us, to be part of the program. So your comments were very valuable. Thank you for all of those. And of course, to all our guests here, our friends from Rotary, our students, and all our friends and colleagues from the college. Maraming salamat po for joining us this afternoon. We would also like to give our special thanks to Ma'am Amy from IHNF. No? Sila po yung bigani as well. Sila po yung kumbaga, really help us to organize the event. Members of the FRAP committee and also the information and the Dean's office for helping us coming up with this very amazing informative event this afternoon. ako na magbigay ng closing message. And this is also my first time to attend a lecture like this, no, of this award. And I'm so happy na you are the one giving this lecture because it's very, it has been very informative. Kagaya nung nabanggit kanina, when you gave me the title of your presentation, it was like parang okay, alien word ito. So today, I have an additional word in my vocabulary, but it's still tongue twister, mahirap siyang i-pronounce. But more than that, it's the relevance, no, ng topic. Coming from Mindanao, actually, we have a common research site ni Ma'am Clara, no? Claverian Misamis Oriental, and that's a very, kumbaga, on my previous work, I was there, no, for 4 years. And corn is the main agricultural crop in the watershed. But then again, yung nabanggit kanina ni Sir Rappi, the truth is, yung the farmers planting white corn, it's already declining because they opt for crops that are, you know, give them better profit. Like for example, hybrid yellow corn. So normally, ito na yung kanilang first cropping. Kasi ngayon, yun na yung white corn. Or other traditional crops like sweet potato and all. So, kumbaga, we want to create the demand kasi nandun yung ano eh, it's a potential, no, na solution to our malnutrition problem, but yung supply. So, once we create the demand, how can we supply, no, yung demand that will be created from that? So, very timely po yung research ninyo, and I guess for IHNF, for CHEC, for the College of Human Ecology, the next challenge will really be on how to disseminate, no, yung knowledge na po, yung information na po to the grassroots, especially doon sa mga brand-producing provinces, no, Isabela, Batignon, and also North Cotabato, kasi yung nandun yung source ng ano eh, yung world. So, you've done a great job on this one, but of course, ang kasunod-kasunod is more work eh. But of course, the college and IHNF, I'm sure, will be supporting you all the way through. And maybe on the part of CHEC, we would like to encourage our faculty to apply for this award. So for this year, we have Ma'am Aimee and also Ma'am Clark who received this prestigious award. So kapag, I'm sure, kung meron pong interesado dito, they will be more than willing to help you know, maybe give tips kung paano po talaga makuha yung award. So if you are interested, just inform the prep committee so we can help you facilitate on your application. So okay po, I know lahat tayo interesado doon sa puto more than disclosing message. So I guess it's time to enjoy the puto from Hanford. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Pinyon, for the message. Okay, so that concludes our program for today. So, thank you everyone for a fruitful event. So, as promised by Dr. Juanito, we will taste puto and a pizza from GS Pizza. So, again, it's been a wonderful afternoon. Thank you everyone and have a good day.